Yes, students, in this video we are going to start the examples of polymers, its synthesis, properties and application. So first we are going to see the formation of polyethylene. Already we have discussed during the example of addition polymerization polyethylene, polyethylene, which monomer is used in polyethylene, ethylene monomer is used. Okay. So how it is formed? It is formed by the ethylene molecule. This is C double bond C. Here hydrogen is present at the four corners. Okay, when that ethylene, n number of ethylene undergoes the polymerization, that time C here is the one, another, so continuously long chain is formed of ethylene molecule, that it is nothing but the polyethylene, where n is a very large integer. Okay, already I said it is 1000, 100, lakh, up to that. Okay, so simply here I would like to show you, this is ethylene, heat, pressure and catalyst, it is going to form N, CH2, here it is double bond, but when it undergoes the polymerization, this double bond is broken, that time it is open like this, and when you are going to show the polymerization, CH2, and at the end, after completion of polymerization to the subscript, you have to show the N. Okay, so this is the polyethylene, it is also called the PE. PE means polyethylene. Next, properties of polyethylene. Polyethylene, it is a rigid, waxy, white, translucent, non-polar material. Okay, it is a rigid, means it is a strong, hard, waxy. When you are going to melt it, it is a waxy like substance, white in color. Okay. Resistant to attack of strong acids, alkalis, salt solution at room temperature. Okay, high temperature it is going to attack, but at room temperature you can store the strong acids, alkalis and salt solution. Okay, polyethylene is a very good insulator of electricity. It is used as a insulator in the electricity. Okay, it has low tensile strength and low softening point. Low softening point means when you are going to hold it on the fire, it is going to get the soften. On heating it is going to become the soft. Okay, it is having the low tensile strength, its tensile strength is also less. These are the properties of polyethylene. Now we are going to see the applications where it is used. It is used for the milk cartons, bowls, buckets, you can see your dustbin, squeezable bottles, that is your ketchup bottles, or drinking water, your Bisleri, Oxyridge, all that it is made from the polyethylene. Okay, cable jacketing, see here, this is the cable copper, as it is a good insulator of electricity, so here the coating of that copper wire, it is wrapped with that polyethylene, as it is the very good insulator. Okay, so this is one application. Another, shopping plastic bags, you have seen the carry bags, all that it is also prepared from the high density polyethylene polymer. Shopping plastic bags, food packing plastics, crates, you are calling it as a carrot, it is not carrot actually, it is the crates, dustbins, drums, detergent bottles, water pipes, all that it is prepared from that your polyethylene. Okay, next you can see for the food packing and all that, that for lamination also, that it is used is your polyethylene. Next, this is your ultra high molecular weight polyethylene, it is used for the bulletproof jackets, all that it is prepared from that ultra high molecular weight polyethylene, you can see it here. Okay, ligament joint or reconstruction, here the material which is used, it is of polyethylene, ultra high molecular weight polyethylene. Here we have finished the polyethylene, now we are going to start the polyvinyl chloride. Okay, so before that I would like to tell you the structure. See here, this is the structure of what? This is the structure of ethylene. Ethylene. When one of the H, it is replaced by the chlorine, one of the hydrogen is replaced by the chlorine, Cl, that time this becomes the vinyl chloride. This is your vinyl chloride. It is called the vinyl chloride. So, formation of polyvinyl chloride, as same, poly, poly means it is the polymer. So which monomer is used here? Vinyl chloride. So what is the structure of vinyl chloride? Same like ethylene, only what you have to do, you have to replace one of the hydrogen by that chlorine, then it becomes the vinyl chloride. Here CH2 double bond CH, this is Cl. Under the heat pressure and catalyst, this double bond is open, that is CH2 CH Cl. N number of, and when it and polymerization is complete, this N you have to show at the subscript. So CH2, this is CH Cl, and N is written here. So this is your polyvinyl chloride. It is called as a PVC. You might heard this name PVC, that is used in the PVC pipes for the agriculture or at your for plumbing in your houses. So you can you might have seen that PVC pipes and all that. Okay. Next, we are going to see the properties of PVC. So what are the properties of PVC? PVC, it is the colorless, odorless, non-inflammable. It is not going to catch the fire and all that. It is not having any smell. It is not having the color. It is chemically inert. It means you are going to store any chemical in it, in the PVC. So there is no action of chemical. It is chemically inert. It is resistant to light and atmospheric oxygen. Okay, resistant means there is no action of the light and atmospheric oxygen on that PVC pipe. Okay, so next, it has greater stiffness and rigidity, but it is the brittle. It is a greater stiffness, stiffness and rigidity, but it is a brittle. Though it is a strong, stiff, but it is the brittle. When you are going to throw it or when suddenly falling, from certain height, that time it is going to break, as it is the brittle. Okay, it possesses high softening point. Like polyethylene, it is not going to soft immediately. Okay, polyethylene, when you are going to heat it, it immediately starts soft, becoming the soft. But here PVC, it is not going to become the soft easily, as its softening point is high. It is the 148 degree Celsius. Its softening point is 148 degree Celsius. Okay. Next, it has excellent water resistance and insulating property. It is not going to absorb the water, and also it is the very good insulator. It is not going to pass the electric current through it. So PVC, it is a very good insulator. Next, we are going to see the properties of that PVC. PVC, that is polyvinyl chloride. These are the applications of the PVC or uses of PVC. First, in the previous slide, we have covered the properties of PVC. It is used for making the sheets employed for tank lining. Okay, you can see a water tank and its lining, inside lining, it is prepared from the PVC. Okay, light fitting, for light fitting, you can see here. Okay, for light fitting also, this is PVC is used. This is PVC, lamp. And outside that, it is prepared from that PVC. Safety helmets, you can see at the construction site also, the safety helmets, they are prepared from the PVC. In MCQ, question might be asked, safety helmets are prepared from which polymer? Polyethylene, polystyrene, polyvinyl chloride. So it is prepared from the polyvinyl chloride. Refrigeration components, tires, cycle motor mudguards, these mudguards, okay, these are prepared from that polyvinyl chloride. So these are the applications of PVC. First we have seen the synthesis or formation of PVC, then its properties, and then the applications. Next we are going to start the Teflon. Teflon, the full form of it, it is a polytetrafluoroethylene. It is called PTFE, polytetrafluoroethylene. Okay, now see here polytetra, which monomer is present here? Remove this poly word, that is tetrafluoroethylene. You are knowing the structure of ethylene. Okay, this is the structure of ethylene where hydrogen is present. When all this hydrogen is replaced by the 4 fluorine atom, okay, at hydrogen is replaced by the fluorine, that time it is the tetrafluoroethylene. So this monomer, when it undergoes the polymerization, here we have to take the, we have to write the N number. First, I'm going to clear this slide. We have to take the N number of the tetrafluoroethylene. It undergoes the polymerization, and after completion of polymerization, don't forget to write the N at the subscript. दिस इज पी टी एफ वी पॉली टेट्रा फ्लोरो इथिलीन. इट इज कॉल्ड द टेफ्लॉन. ओके टेफ्लॉन टेप्स यू माइट हैव सीन एट योर होम ऑल्सो. ओके सो दिस इज द what to say tetrafluoroethylene polytetrafluoroethylene it is called the teflon. It is having high molecular weight, low coefficient of friction, it has low chemical reactivity, it is resistant to water and alcohol, means it is not having any action of water and alcohol. It is harder, stronger than the other polymer. Okay, this is important property, that is it is a harder and stronger than the other polymers. Okay, see here, it is used in containers and pipe work for reactive and corrosive chemicals. Okay, you can see there, as it is having low chemical reactivity, it is going to show which property? It is going to show the low chemical reactivity. So it is used for the corrosive chemicals, okay, for storing of that. Next, it is used in insulating material for motor, transformer, cable, wires, etc. You can see here wire, okay, this wire it is used as it is the very good insulator. It is used for making gaskets, tank lining and packings. Okay, you can see here gasket. You are knowing the gasket in cooker also, that ring is present. We are calling ring, but actually it is not ring, it is the gasket. All that gaskets are prepared from the Teflon. Okay, in your mixture jar also, for the packing, thorough packing of that, inside that there is a one wire, what to say, one ring is there. Okay, that it is called the gasket, and all that gasket it is prepared from the Teflon. Next, it is commonly used as a craft material in the surgical interventions. Means mostly it is used in the dental surgical instruments. So for the grafting means what? Removing the skin from other side and pasting it on the other surface. It is called the grafting. And mostly in dental work it is used, Teflon it is used in the dental work. Okay, next polymer that we are going to see the application and synthesis of that is the phenol formaldehyde bakelite. Okay, today we will stop here. See you in next lecture.